reading from Ephesians chapter 6, verse 11 through 18. Put on the armor of God, that ye may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. Wherefore, take unto you the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to withstand in the evil day, and have done all to stand. Stand therefore, having your loins girt about with truth, having on the breastplate of righteousness, and your feet shod with the preparation of the gospel of peace. Above all, taking the shield of faith, wherewith ye shall be able to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked.
Fiery darts.
And take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. Praying always with all prayer and supplication in the Spirit, and watching thereunto with all perseverance and supplication for all saints. Amen.
Amen.
You all may be seated. I want to first off give a little testimony of myself. Some odd 31, almost 31 years ago, next month, I had my daughter at 17 years old. Somewhere along the line, there was a problem. And on the 11th of July, I started to have seizures. And they didn't know why. And my mom is here and can attest that they told my parents that if I lived, I would be in a vegetative state, meaning I would be able to walk, talk, take care of my child. But God had a different plan for me. I am walking. I not only can talk, I woke up speaking, walking, talking. I had another child who was safe and sound. No matter what obstacles we face in life, no matter what doctors or anyone tells you, God is a healer. He is alive and well.
Yeah.
I'm a true walking, living testimony that doctors have degrees, but he is the doctrine of everything.
Yeah. Yes, ma'am.
So with that being said, the whole armor of God, what does that mean? That means God has given us in this one book the key to life, all the obstacles we will face. His word said, as I just read, we will face principalities. We will face wickedness. We will have obstacles that will come. His word never told us that everything would be smooth. He said, follow me. I am the truth, the light, and the way. That means with our whole heart, we have to give it all to God.
Yeah.
I'm going to give you an example. When those bills come and we know that we have more that needs to go out than coming in.
Take your time.
We go down a little bit. When we get calls and someone has passed away or we have a sick relative, it takes us down a little bit more. Late in the midnight hour, when no one knows the pain that you are enduring and the obstacles that you face, that you may or may not even talk about, it takes us down just a little bit more. To the point where we don't know sometimes when we walk in a job or we will walk out with one, that takes us down just a little bit more.
Yeah.
But what we have to learn to do and what God has asked us to do, give it to me. And we as human beings, sometimes we try to fix it for ourselves. I'm going to show you a way that you fix it. Thank you, Jesus. When you start to go down, when you can't figure it out, when you don't know what to do next, when you can't, when you've done all that you say you can do, when we've gone and prayed, and we say, Lord, help me. Help me, Jesus. Help me fix it.
I don't know how to fix it. My kids is acting up. My husband, a girlfriend, is acting up. I'm still being fervent in prayer. I'm going to a job I don't know. They talking about layoffs. Will it be me? I'm already robbing Peter to pay Paul. I have so much anguish, but yet I smile. People call me and say, how you doing? And in the late night hour, you know, Lord, I'm hurting, and I tell them I'm okay. I tell them things will be fine, because I'm keeping a positive attitude. But sometimes when life just weighs you down, you gotta hit your knees. And you gotta say, Lord, help me, Jesus. I give it to you in my own heart. Only you can fix the things that I need to be fixed, Lord. Help me to understand these obstacles. Help me to understand why these things are going on. I put your whole armor on, Lord. Please take it from my heart, my mind, my body, my soul. Give me your spirit, Lord. Give me the strength to stand and to endure the things that you told me in your word you would do. Thank you, Jesus. I thank you for all that you are and all that you do. Your word says you would not put no more on me than I can bear. And I'm asking you, Father, just to take it away. When my kids is acting up, just cover them, Lord. When I don't understand the principalities and the things that are forming against me, Lord, I give it to you, Father, with my whole heart, my mind, my body, my soul. When you stand, you are girded the armor of God. The word says you should have on the helmet. When you go to war, you remember the old movies in the day. They had on war gear. He's telling us, listen to the description. Loins, truth, breastplate, here, a shield of faith, a helmet of salvation, a sword of the spirit. That means when you stand up after giving all God, all that you have to give, you are a warrior in the faith. He is with you. He guards you. So what you do is you stand. And as they stand in the war, all the opposition coming towards them, you get prepared for whatever is coming. And what you say is, my God says, he will never leave me, never forsake me. He told me that I am the way, the truth, and the life. So I shall fight my way through these obstacles, and I'm going to make it. God, help me. You are the ultimate shield. You give me the ultimate faith to know that I give it all to you, Lord. I give you my whole heart, my mind, my body, and soul. And we need to start. We will go to the self-help books and say, I try to understand a man when he acting up, trying to understand a woman. Men are from Venus, women are from Mars. 100 ways for dummies. When we got it all right here. This is everything we face in this life. There is nothing that we can't go to in this world for our obstacles. To face our truths. To understand that God has a purpose for each and every one of us, no matter what we go through, no matter what we face, we gird ourselves because it's not going to be easy. And I'm not up here saying that it's going to be easy, but we can fight our way through it. God wants us to keep the faith. Trust me. And when you don't know what else to do, you call out in the name of Jesus, help me, Jesus, help me, Jesus. That is the answer and the key. He will never fail you. He will always be there for you. He will take care of things that man can't do for you. We can come where the word says, where two or more gather, yep, there he shall be.
Right.
So what we need to start doing is get some, be careful about who you're praying, how praying over you and for you. But we need to find a prayer partner that's in the word of God. And if you have to tell them, you help me. I'm facing this. I need your prayer. We need help. I need to know that somebody is believing in me, that somebody is trusting in me.
Right.
And I tell you, God will come through.
Yep.
We pray over your children, because in the world today, the devil is trying to take our kids where they're so disrespectful, some of them, and the devil is trying to get through your household. You better stand in your living room and say, devil, you will not be, you have no place. start standing to the devil just like you would stand to another human being and tell him about himself, you better stand against the devil and get him to flee. The word tells us that by the name of Jesus, the devil and the evil principalities will flee. Get him out of your household. Get him out of your car. Pray over your car on the way to your job. When you get to your job, you pray over your job. You pray over your cubicle, office, or wherever it is, because there's evil people in companies too. You pray to keep your job. And if you happen to lose your job, and it's hard, we're trying to figure out how we're going to do it, it's not the end of the world. Sometimes God moves things to move you to something better. Some people you love, he will remove them out of for something better. That may not have been the man for you. That may not have been the woman for you. God knows better when he knows your heart.
Amen.
What he wants from us, people.
Amen.
Keep the faith. Trust in him. It's hard sometimes. While I'm talking to you, I'm encouraging myself.
Amen.
Sometimes you got to take your wallet and pray over it. You got to take them bills and pray over them. Sometimes you got to take your children and they don't even know, but you just go and you touch them. Touch your husband. Touch your man. They don't even know why. Bringing God to your home.
Amen.
Take him everywhere you go. It's hard sometimes. We try to fight on our own. But we got the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords on our side. And nothing nobody can do or say can take us away. Anything that happens is God's purpose. Even in our hardest times, it is God's purpose. And sometimes we women, we have to stop bashing these men and our fathers and our kids' fathers sometimes. Pray about it, even if he ain't right.
Right, man.
Pray about it.
Right.
Pray about it. Because sometimes these women are saying his deadbeat dad, but he calling you to see his kids because he ain't giving the right dollar amount. You want to say no and keeping the kids, but don't nobody know but you and him. We got to stop that too. It is hard out here. And men are facing obstacles we just don't understand. Where they go, these brothers is facing it every day. We see it on the news. What's going on? When they walk out the house, you don't know if they're coming back. By the grace of God, they do. You need to start praying over these men, your brothers, your cousins, and everybody else. And I'm not saying we as women don't need to be prayed for, but they face obstacles and things that we don't face. And we would never understand, because think about the word saying they have to be the provider. They have to be the caretaker. They have to be the daddy. They have to face certain people in this world. They have to face the legal system, unfair as it is. They could be driving to the job to make the money to provide for you, get pulled over, unfortunate circumstances happen, and we crying. Cover them when they walk out the door, whether you're mad or not. Cover them when you walk out the door. I'm here to say, keep the faith, people, keep the faith. Give it to Jesus, give it to Jesus. Nothing is too hard for our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ.